welcome to St Michael's Carol Service, whether you're here in person or watching online. I know a lot of our congregation watch online these days because they don't like coming out in the dark, and there are people who can watch it at different times rather than at this moment. Well, my name is Rosemary Freeman, and I'm the Associate Minister here. But this evening we have a cast of thousands, absolute thousands, some of whom are doubling in different roles. So thank you to all of you, and a special thank you to Lynn Wilson, the band, well, the brass band, I should say, the brass band from Abraham Darby Academy. A very special thank you to you. It's lovely to see you. I think carols are special when they're accompanied by brass, but perhaps I'm a bit biased. Anyway, the service itself will flow through without any interruptions or speech from me. This is about all you're going to see of me, except for prayers. But before we actually get into the rest of the service, a notice about safety. In the event of having to leave the building in a hurry, the unlikely event, I think I should say, of having to leave the building in a hurry. The exits are where you came in, and that side and that side. And the muster point is the green outside the main entrance. After the service, coffee, tea, mince pies, squash will be served. And also, Jan, our reader, has brought some packs of candles and little messages, and they're on the back table. So when you leave, if you'd like to take one of those with you, a Christmas present from us, then please do. Please stand for the carols, if you're able, and sit for everything else. It's quite straightforward. So without further ado, we'll continue in prayer. Lord, we pray for each person here and each family represented tonight. We give thanks that you hold every single one of us in your hand, and we pray that as we join together in your presence here and elsewhere, we will take the blessing we receive out into the cold air, then back into the warmth of our families, so that our Christmas will be truly filled with your love. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Mary,
1:26-38. In the sixth month of Elizabeth's pregnancy, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. The virgin's name was Mary. The angel went to her and said, "Greetings, you who are highly favoured, the Lord is with you." Mary was greatly troubled at his words and wondered what kind of greeting this might be. But the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favour with God. You will conceive and give birth to a son, and you are to call him Jesus. He will be great, and he will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over Jacob's descendants forever. His kingdom will never end." "How will this be?" Mary asked the angel. "Since I am a virgin," the angel answered, "the Holy Spirit will come on you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God. Even Elizabeth, your relative, is going to have a child in her old age, and she, who was said to be unable to conceive, is in her sixth month. For no word from God will ever fail." "I am the Lord's servant," Mary answered. "May your word to me be fulfilled." Then the angel left her.
Welcome to this week's edition of
Surprise, Surprise!
The TV show that is just full of surprises.
And this week, we're in a small town in the hill country of Judah.
At the home of an elderly couple called Elizabeth and Zechariah.
They're expecting a visit from Elizabeth's niece, a young woman called Mary.
But they have a surprise in store when Mary arrives.
And we will be here to record it on
Surprise, Surprise!
Are you Zechariah and Elizabeth?
Yes, we are. What's going on?
Zechariah and Elizabeth, you are this week's guests on
Surprise, Surprise!
Oh no, not more surprises.
Now, Zechariah, tell us about the surprise you had in the temple 6 months back.
You'll have to excuse him. He's lost his voice.
I've lost my voice.
This angel, you see, he told Zechariah that after all these years, we were at last going to have a baby.
That must have been a big surprise for you.
Yes, we were stunned. In fact, he hasn't spoken since.
So, here you are, older than the hills itself, and expecting a baby.
Yes, amazing, isn't it?
And any moment now, you're expecting a visit from your cousin Mary.
That's right.
Well, Elizabeth and Zechariah, there's another surprise awaiting for you.
And here she comes now, direct from Nazareth, engaged to be married to Joseph, your young niece, Mary.
And the surprise is that she too is...
Mary. Sorry, I've lost myself. Mary, dear Mary, blessed are you among women. The moment I saw you, the baby jumped in my womb for joy, for you too are to bear a child.
Oh, that was the surprise.
The mother
of my Lord.
Yes, I've been told by an angel I will give birth to a son. We will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. His kingdom will never end.
Praise the Lord. Come, Mary, you must stay with us.
That young woman is the mother of the Lord.
The child is to be named Jesus.
He will be great.
The Son of the Most High.
His kingdom will never end.
Zechariah, do you have any comment on these amazing events?
Yes.
And my brother Tommy had a cap on it as well. Yeah,
Surprise, surprise!
I don't get to give give Iris my microphone.
Welcome to this week's edition of
Surprise, Surprise!
The TV show that is just full of surprises.
Today, we are in Nazareth.
And we've got a surprise in store for the man who lives in this house.
A local carpenter named Joseph.
Now, he's getting married tomorrow.
But our researchers have found out something that might make him think again.
Joseph, are you there?
Yes.
Come on out here.
Surprise.
Surprise.
Oh, not that.
Yes, Joseph, you are this week's guest on
Surprise, Surprise. Surprise.
What, me? On telly? Oh.
Now, Joseph, tomorrow's a big day, right?
Yeah, I'm getting married.
And the name of the lucky lady?
Mary.
You love her lots and lots.
Yes.
And nothing will stop you marrying her tomorrow?
Nothing.
Well, we'll see about that.
Because we've got a surprise for you, Joseph.
Oh, good. I like surprises.
I don't think you'll like this one.
Mary's having a baby.
Surprise, surprise.
Oh, that? That's not a surprise.
What?
I've known about that for ages.
And you're still going to marry her?
Yes. By the way, it's going to be a boy, and they're going to call him Jesus, and he's going to be a special baby. God's son, in fact, brought into the world by God's Holy Spirit. And Mary, she's going to be his mum.
But how do you know all this?
Ah, an angel told us.
An angel?
Yes. Surprise, surprise.
Chapter 2, verses 1 to 7. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria, and everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in clothes and placed him in a manger because there was no guest room available for them.
Welcome to this week's edition of Surprise, Surprise, the TV show that's just full of surprises.
And today, we are with the crowds in Bethlehem.
And we've got a surprise in store for Mary and Joseph, who are just about to arrive from Nazareth.
But first, let's speak to some people in the crowd. Excuse me, Mrs., but is Bethlehem always as crowded as this?
No, it's the census. They're all here for the census. Everyone has to return to the town their family comes from.
So, where have you come from?
Ooh. Oh, I live there. I live over there, in the hotel. It's so busy, it's packed up, but there's no room.
No room?
No room.
And that's the surprise we have in store for Mary and Joseph.
Here they come now.
Joseph, Mary, over here. Joseph and Mary from Nazareth, for you, it's...
Surprise, surprise!
Not again. What now?
Joseph and Mary, you're here from Nazareth for the census, right?
Yes.
And you, Mary, are expecting a baby, right?
Yeah, yes. Any day now.
And this baby is to be special, right?
Yes, the Son of God.
Saviour.
the saviour of the world.
So where exactly are you planning to stay?
In that hotel over there.
Surprise, surprise, it's full.
Packed out.
Not a room to spare.
And here's the biggest surprise for you, Mary. Will have Mary, will have to give birth in your first child.
The one you say is to be the saviour of the world.
The Son of God.
In that dirty, old, smelly stable over there.
Surprise, surprise.
Oh. God's full of surprises, isn't he? You're going to be all right over there in that stable.
It's God's plan, Joseph. It's God's plan.
This reading is from Luke 2, verses 8 to 20. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a saviour has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom his favour rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby, who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told.
On the fifth day of Christmas, my true love sent to me eighth day of Christmas, my true love sent to me. Eight cattle lowing, seven angels singing, six people shouting, glory,
welcome to this week's edition of
Surprise, Surprise!
The TV show that's just full of surprises.
Today, we're on a hillside just outside Bethlehem.
And we've got a surprise in store for some guys who spend most of their time up here looking after sheep.
A bunch of unlikely lads.
No one trusts these shepherds.
Dishonest. Crooks.
The men that everyone loves to hate.
The last people you'd invite to a party.
The last people you'd invite to anything.
But tonight, we've got a surprise in store for them.
Our researchers have discovered that these shepherds have been chosen for a very special invitation.
Oh, I do believe they're coming now.
Excuse me, you lot. Can you stop for a moment?
Sorry, we're in a hurry.
Got to get to Bethlehem.
But hold on a bit. Don't you realise who we are? This is...
Surprise, surprise!
Well, make it quick then.
Thank you. Now, you lot are just a bunch of poor, dirty, smelly, scruffy, ugly, dishonest shepherds, right?
Yes.
Well, tonight we have a surprise in store for you.
Not another one.
Yes, of all the people in the world, you have been chosen to go to Bethlehem.
And to look for a stable where you will find a newborn baby.
Yeah, lying in a manger.
But not any baby. This one's special.
His name's Jesus. He's the Son of God.
The Saviour of the world.
And you, of all people, have been chosen to go there.
Yeah.
Do you know that?
Yes, we do know that.
Is that where you're going now?
Yeah, we're off there now, yeah.
Who told you?
That's where we're going.
How do you know this?
We're going there now to worship him.
I thought you might be. How do you know this already?
Because an angel told us.
An angel?
Yes. Yes. Surprise, surprise. Bye.
Thank you. The reading is taken from Matthew chapter 2, reading verses 1 to 12. After Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea, during the time of King Herod, Magi from the east came to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the one who has been born King of the Jews? We saw his star when it rose and have come to worship him." When Herod heard this, he was disturbed, and all Jerusalem with him. When he had called together all the priests, chiefs, and teachers of the law, he asked them where the Messiah was to be born. "In Bethlehem in Judea," they replied, "for this is what the prophet has written. But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judea, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah. For out of you will come a ruler who will shepherd my people Israel." Herod called the Magi secretly and found out from them the exact time the star had appeared. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search carefully for the child. As soon as you find him, report to me, so that I too may go and worship him." After they had heard the king, they went on their way, and the star they had seen when it rose went ahead of them, until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed. On coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to go back to Herod, they returned to their country by another route.
Thank you.
the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through him all things were made. Without him nothing was made that has been made. In him was life, and that life was the light of all mankind. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify concerning that light, so that through him all might believe. He himself was not the light. He came only as a witness to the light, the true light that gives light to everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and though the world was made through him, the world did not recognize him. He came to that which was his own, but his own did not receive him. Yet to all who did receive him, to those who believed in his name, he gave the right to become children of God. Children born not of natural descent, nor of human decision or a husband's will, but born of God. The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only Son, who came from the Father, full of grace and truth.
Peace on earth, peace on earth, the angels sing.
Let us pray. All over the world, this is a time of celebration, a time for rejoicing and feasting. Yet we remember today, amidst all the joy, those whose hearts are heavy. We pray for those who will not be celebrating because they have lost touch with their families. Those who wish it could be different, but because recrimination and regret lie heavy, taking the first step towards reconciliation is difficult. We pray for all those for whom this time of Christmas is difficult, with just memories to keep them company. Those whose families seem incomplete. Their contemporaries diminishing year by year. We pray for those who have lost a child and whose memories of loss are heightened by the reference to happy children and family celebration. We pray for those who are in prison trying to make the best of it, and their families who feel the punishment of waiting. We pray for those who are far away in war zones, keeping an uneasy watch, and those who wait at home with anxious hearts. We pray for those who are in homeless shelters off the streets for a few days, given a feast by the goodwill of others. We pray for all those people around the world who can only dream of feasts and what it's like to feel full. God, whose name is love, you came to turn the world upside down. May we help you in that task, whatever that may mean for us. Amen. And before our final carol and refreshments, a blessing on each one of you. May the joy of the angels, the eagerness of the shepherds, the perseverance of the wise men, the obedience of Mary, and the peace of the Christ child be yours this Christmas, and the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be with each one of you and those you love this night, this Christmas, and always. Amen. Christmas, I think we should give the band a round of applause. Thank you so much. The drinks are on the house.
Do you like it?